Hey guys, Jeff here. And before we get to today's episode, I wanted to let you know about our Season 4 sponsor, Adventure Is Out There Travel. If you're listening to this podcast, there's a pretty good chance that you're in the middle of planning your next Disney vacation right now. So why not make it easier for yourself? By working with an Adventure Is Out There travel agent, you'll be having an experienced vacation planner doing the heavy lifting for you. Adventure Is Out There Travel specializes in making sure your entire group gets to experience the type of activities they want in order to make your trip even more magical. Whether heading to a Walt Disney World vacation in Orlando, flying west to Disneyland, or floating on the high seas in a Disney cruise, Adventure Is Out There Travel can help you plan the vacation of a lifetime. Visit AdventureIsOutThereTravel.com for your free, no-obligation quote today. Now on with the show.
Are you craving a trip on Space Mountain? Well, we've got the next best thing. Welcome to Disney Coast to Coast.
Hey, folks, and welcome to Disney Coast to Coast, the ultimate unofficial Disney fan podcast. I'm Jeff DePauly.
And I'm Aaron Fairbanks.
It's almost Halloween.
It's almost Halloween.
Oh, boy.
I love Halloween.
Okay.
Yeah, I love Halloween. I'm so excited for Halloween. What is it, Tuesday?
You like the scarier stuff in Halloween. I like the, like...
Yeah.
Candy and decorations.
I like, honestly, though, I like everything Halloween. Yeah, I like, like retro Halloween.
Right.
I like autumnal Halloween.
You know what? I know you like fog fluid.
I love
fog
fluid.
So I'm sure what we're going to be talking about this week, there's one thing I know you must have been pretty, I think
I know what you're talking
pretty
about.
Pretty excited about. I thought it must have been pretty cool.
Yeah, so it is almost Halloween. Tuesday is Halloween. Halloween 2017 is here, and I'm so excited and also so depressed because it means it's almost over.
It means it's almost Christmas.
It doesn't mean it's only the next day. It will be Christmas
at
Disney.
Yeah.
So I think I've told this story on the show before. I'm not going to mention a name just in case he doesn't want me to say, although I can't imagine he would care. But a friend of mine who is involved in the Disney fan community loves Christmas so much that on Halloween at midnight, when midnight rings in, he starts blasting Christmas music and hanging Christmas decorations, which I think is such a fun little, little kickoff for the holidays. So, like I said, I don't think he would care. He's probably listening to this, so I'll keep my mouth shut just in case. But before we get to the Halloween stuff we want to talk about on this week's episode, I got to talk to you about something.
What?
I am an official one-time user.
Oh,
of the Max Pass.
That's right.
Yeah.
I can't believe I haven't talked to you since.
Well, I've specifically not talked about it with you because I wanted to do it on.
I'd almost
air
like
here.
Forgotten about it.
Well,
so,
I am, and I got to tell you something. I loved it. And do you want to know why I loved it? Because I got it for free. Bam.
Did somebody else pay for it?
No, it's Disney paid for it. I got it for free because it was so difficult and I had so many problems with it that they eventually gave it to me and my sister and were like, just take it. And then they gave us free bonus fast passes on top of it.
What happened?
Okay, so here's a good little tip that Aaron gave me that I tried to take advantage of. It didn't work for me. So the way that the MaxPass works, if you're not familiar with MaxPass, this is basically a $10 per day add-on to the Disneyland app so that you can book fast passes without having to go to the location of the actual attraction.
Right.
That's the easy version of it. Actually, that was quite a good description of it. Good job, Jeff. Pat on the back. I like that. But so the way that it works is you have to have been scanned into the park with your ticket in order to activate this MaxPass. So Aaron, you said to me, hey, if you want to start booking the Max Passes earlier, go to the monorail. That way, when they scan you into the park at the monorail, you can already start downloading and booking and all that jazz.
Right.
So that's what I did. Now, I will say, I do not suggest this if you are a first-time visitor or an infrequent visitor. The proper entrance to Disneyland is and always will be the main gate under the railroads onto Main Street USA. But if you visit frequently, like I do and like my sister has, we opted into this. So I was thrilled. I was like, great, we're going to do this. I'm going to download it. It's going to work out beautifully. I could not get my ticket to hook up to it. There were just problems. Wow. I was like, well, that was a waste. So I end up at guest relations in Tomorrowland. This guy couldn't help. In fact, he made it worse because he was like, well, try logging out of your Disney app and then log back in. So I log out. And it doesn't allow me to log back in. I'm like, are you kidding me?
Oh my gosh, there's
a lot that goes to this story. I guess I'll tell it all. So he ends up giving us a bonus fast pass. He takes off Haunted Mansion Holiday. He takes off Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy. And he takes off Guardians of the Galaxy.
Those are Monsters ones you After Dark.
We could not use those. He did leave on Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout.
Nice.
So it's like, sweet. We're going to use it for that. So he couldn't help. He's like, you got to go to City Hall to really get this fixed.
Oh my gosh.
So I go to City Hall. Line is huge. And by the way, this is one day I'm spending at Disneyland with my sister, like from Boston. So I didn't, you know, want to waste her day. So I was really angry. I was like, I got to wait in this City Hall line because a cast member told me to do something that essentially broke the So in any case, I say, forget it. I'm going to DCA. Instead, their line will be shorter. So that's a nice little tip, too. If you need guest relations and you have a park hopper, go to DCA. The line is much shorter than City Hall. Go there. They kind of figure it out. Then they're like, okay, now you're just going to do this to pay for it. Couldn't pay for it. It was like giving her, and the girl was just like, you know what? Forget about it. And she just puts it on and we take off. And so we got it for free. So I loved it because it was for free. So remember that whole Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout free fast pass I get?
Yeah.
So I go to the ride and I'm like, I'm going to use this. And the girl there is like, you can't use it for this ride. It's a new ride. And I was like, no, we were told we could. The guy took off Monsters After Dark, but we can use it for the date. Time, blah, 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 back, front. Now you can't use that. And she's like, look at the list of rides you can. And she pulls up the list on my phone. And I go, oh, yeah, see this one here? It's called Mission Breakout.
It said it on the phone?
I'm like, so, fine, try it. And so I try it.
Well, that's why I'm confused. Well, because
it was my first time. I wasn't sure exactly what to do. Oh, so I was kind of asking for help. Gotcha. And she's like, oh, no, you can't do that here.
Yeah.
And so...
Because it's digital. It's like they have no power here anymore.
So I scan it. It works. Yeah. And the girl was the egg on the face. And I was like, yeah.
I hope you said that. Exactly.
I was not a happy camper. So...
Was that the first thing you rode?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Because I was like, we don't have to spend our time getting this. Let's do it. Right. My sister freaking loved Mission Breakout.
Awesome.
It was like, we must do Monsters After Dark. So we did that as well. As far as system's concerned, it's great. It should be free. I still stand by that. It should be free.
Yeah.
But it's a fantastic system. Once it worked, which took about an hour for us, it worked beautifully. One thing I really loved about it, if you're used to the Magic Band system at Walt Disney World, this is a much faster scanning system. So with the Magic Band, you have to tap the thing, and it like takes, you know, it's fast, but it's the Max Pass is much faster. It's like bloop, go, as opposed to wing, 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 bloop. So, I mean, is it that much of a difference? Not really, but...
You're saving time.
You're saving seconds throughout the day.
Yeah.
So it was great for that. Overall, it's exactly what I expected. It was nice. I could connect my sister's ticket to my apps and just book both of them. It's a great thing. I wish it were free. And for one day, I had it for free. So I'm a huge... So I give it a 98% considering the problems we had at the beginning. If it wasn't free, I'd give it like an 80%.
Wow, that's still pretty high.
No, it's a great thing. It's exactly what I expected.
That's like a solid B-.
Yeah. It's close to average.
Yeah.
So as I've said since the beginning, if you're a tourist, do it. Spend the $10 or have it break your phone and get it for free.
Now, here's the thing. Did you just tried to buy it on your phone, right?
Yeah.
Outright when you got into the park.
Once I was scanned in at the monorail on Downtown Disney, I tried to purchase it. And it wouldn't let me.
Now, I would be interested. Can you buy it beforehand?
No. Because I tried. I'm pretty sure I tried because I tried to like do it here. And then I was like, couldn't find what to hit. And then I remembered you saying, oh, they got to scan your ticket. And I was like, okay, it's probably that. And then once they scanned my ticket, there was like another button option.
Okay.
If I'm remembering correctly.
Then personally,
mm-hmm.
I would dock off. Like 5 or 10% from your 80% because
75%.
If they're gonna charge you for it, they should make it way easier to purchase it.
Here's the thing. I'm sure it's not normally difficult. I'm sure people are listening to this and saying, wow, I had zero problem whatsoever buying it.
I mean,
it was weird, and then it just got worse. When the cast members tried to help, it got worse. And then on top of that, it was just like insane lines and stuff. So it was just a snowball effect that it got to a point of, geez, we need some magic. Bam, free max passes. Bam, bonus max pass. Thank you. You're welcome. Moving on. And I deleted them. And I will say I deleted the mean tweets after that because I had some angry tweets and I was going back and forth with Disneyland today. And I deleted the mean ones and left complimentary ones for the cast member who helped me out.
Nice.
So I will say that.
That's what's important.
That's very important. I don't want to leave the mean stuff out there. No. I just want to get it fixed. And frankly, I will say, at least at the Disneyland Resort, if you tweet at Disneyland today, they don't like mean tweets about them out there. And I'm not saying to just make up mean stuff, but if you're having a problem, I would certainly tweet at them, and they respond pretty well. So just putting that out there. But anyway, that is not what this episode's about. I just wanted to mention it to you because I know you're a huge MaxPass fan. So shall we get to the Halloween goodness that is today's episode?
Yeah, let's.
Let's do it.
Get ready to dig deep in today's Disney dialogue.
So as we mentioned, Halloween is just around the corner, and this year at the, of course, Disney celebrates Halloween across their parks. We've, on past seasons, talked a lot about Halloween at the Disney parks, so I really wanted to focus on the new this year.
New!
When you talk about new Halloween in the Disney parks, nobody got bigger new stuff than Disney California Adventure.
Oh, yeah.
It was quite an exciting year for Disney California Adventure, but did you know this? I've seen a lot of people tweeting like, oh, you know, like DCA is finally getting Halloween decorations and stuff. Not the first time at all. Do you remember, what was it called, Candy Corn Acres?
No, I...
You weren't here?
Was not here.
Okay. No. So back in DCA 1.0, back in the day with the giant sun and the Golden Gate Bridge and all that stuff, they had what they called Candy Corn Acres, where basically there were candy corn everywhere. They had like candy corn growing on corn stalks. They had a giant candy corn in front of the sun. Wow. I actually really liked it. It was probably really tacky.
Do you like candy corn?
I love candy corn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I'm a fan of original candy corn. I don't need them in the shape of pumpkins. Their little triangle shape is beautiful and retro and fantastic.
Have you seen all the new kinds of
candy corn? I don't want to, no.
There's like a candy apple.
Is there butterbeer candy corn?
I don't think so, but there are.
That would be good.
There are vampire teeth.
Oh, okay.
And they got little red.
Just give me classic candy corn. No. That's all I want. I also only want it this time of year. I don't want it for Christmas. I don't want a red, white, and green candy corn, which I think is a thing.
It is.
It's a Halloween treat. I love it. So Candy Corn Acres is a wonderful thing. It was a wonderful thing. I remember really liking it. And from 2005 to 2009, Mickey's Halloween Party, which has gone through several name changes, was actually over at Disney California Adventure. And the reason for it moving to Disneyland was very much because DCA was going through such massive, massive construction for DCA
2.0.
And it's just kind of stayed there ever since, but maybe changing in the near future. I don't know. Well, we shall wait and see. But good for you. You knew it. Halloween used to be there.
Yeah.
Love it. Cool. But let's talk about this year's Halloween. And let's start at the entrance of the park, shall we?
Yeah. Well, I like the theme of this, especially because I'm a big Nightmare Before Christmas fan, but they've
Let me ask you a question before we go.
Yeah.
Are you a big fan of the film or a big fan of the characters or both? Or like, where does your Nightmare Before Christmas fandom live? Because I love the characters, I love the music, but it's not like a film that every Halloween season I'm like, I need to pop that in. Like,
oh yeah.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it a Halloween movie or a Christmas movie for you?
It's a Hollow Christmas Ween.
Hollow Christmas Ween. All right.
I don't know. It borders so well, so I feel like I can watch it.
I think you can watch it whenever, but I relate it more to Halloween.
Yeah, I do as well.
Leave a comment below on YouTube. Let us know. Is Nightmare Before Christmas a Halloween or a Christmas movie for you?
Yeah, I love the movie, and I remember seeing it when the year that it came out.
Uh-huh.
And it just left such an impression. So maybe that's part of why I love the film.
I remember seeing it in the movie theater because I'm old enough to have done that. And I remember It's very short. Like, what is it, 82 minutes or something?
Yeah,
like?
It's pretty short. Yeah.
I just remember, you know, the system when I was growing up was my mom would drop us off at the movie theater because I was too young to drive. And I'd call my mom after the movie and say, hey, movie's over. And I just remember calling my mom and be like, hey, mom, the movie's over. And her being like, what? She's like, it's over already? And like, she's like, I just dropped you off. I don't know why I remember that, but I have that memory.
Wow.
Anyway.
It is short.
Anyway, so back to DCA.
Anyways, so I was really excited that they kind of created a lore for why Halloween had come to DCA this year.
Mm-hmm.
And it's because Oogie Boogie has taken over Disney California Adventure, and he's wrought his Halloween evilness. Mischief. I won't say evilness. His mischief on the park.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm interested to see. I feel like it kind of almost like plays against Disneyland because of that, because Disneyland has the Haunted Mansion Holiday and Jack and Sally are there. So is there almost like this rivalry between the two parks now?
You know, what'd be really interesting is if they took Oogie Boogie out of Haunted Mansion Holiday because he's at DCA.
Well,
that would be interesting.
It's weird because I almost had that thought when I wrote it, where I was like, oh, it's kind of weird that Oogie's here because he's...
I mean, Mickey's in both places.
He's supposed to be over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's like a time jump Mickey. Like, he's 1920s
okay.
Mickey, and then he's like modern-day Mickey.
Fair enough.
I don't know.
But now, this entrance is beautiful. If you have not seen it, it's a beautiful yellow full moon. This is over the turnstiles of DCA.
Yeah.
Beautiful yellow full moon with an Oogie Boogie silhouette with like these long branches that extend out, black silhouettes. Absolutely beautiful. Like, I don't know anybody that has walked by that and not immediately been like, I need a photo. Like,
yeah.
That is so, so cool. The one complaint I will have about it is that the seam is so visible during the daytime.
Yeah.
Like, the seam where the pieces of wood meet.
Well, you know what's weird, too, is that the print on the backside of it.
Uh-huh.
Is really good. Like, it's seamless. It's,
huh.
Because and I think that's a nice touch, too, that as you walk out of the park, you just see the full moon.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that one looks really good. So
yeah, the seam bothers me. At nighttime, you do not notice it at all. But I was just like, it just looks a little bit like community theater in that respect. I'm like, really? How did this not get, you know, taped or plastered or whatever to make it a seamless seam?
Yeah.
Small,
a seamless seam.
Yeah. Small details, but regardless, that's such a simple plus that I'm like, really? Who ran out of budget, couldn't afford enough plaster for that or whatever. But yeah, it's a beautiful entrance to DCA. I love it.
Yeah.
And throughout, like, I don't know how often is it, every 10 minutes or something, Oogie Boogie, like, speaks out there.
Yeah.
Like, as you're waiting, if there's a long line in DCA, you'll hear him say some different sort of phrase or whatever. And it's really cool. It's just a great mood setter for Halloween DCA. Then we go through the turnstile onto Buena Vista Street.
Right.
And it's decked out.
It's like 1920s Halloween.
Yeah.
It's which I,
you know what I want to know?
What?
When did purple become a Halloween color? I think it works beautifully as a Halloween color, but it's always been like, as a kid, I just remember black and orange, black and orange. Everything's black and orange. And like somewhere in the last decade, I feel like purple has really become a Halloween color.
Some brilliant designer who's just like,
purple and black work.
What goes really well with these two colors?
Purple and black, beautiful.
We need a third color.
Purple, black, and orange.
Yeah. I love
candy corn. Candy corn. Purple, black, orange, candy corn. No.
Wait, you would be okay?
No.
With that? Oh, okay.
I'm just saying. Okay. We just need the original.
I really like the... So they have purple banners on everything.
Yeah.
And they have these... they have bats everywhere.
Yes.
And I love that it is... it's not super technical. They have...
Very handcrafted.
Yeah, it's very handcrafted, but it's not... Community theater. It's not cheap. It looks good.
It looks better than Small World.
Oh.
You know, like, when I think handcrafted, I think Small World.
Yeah.
But, like, Small World really looks handcrafted. This looks, like, professionally handcrafted. Does that make sense?
Sure.
Am I crapping on Small World?
I would say that not all of Small World is that bad, but if you get to, like, Jesse and Woody and... in America that...
And even, like, I always think of, like, what looks like a papier-mâché hippo.
Oh, yeah.
Like, just that very handcrafted, on purpose. I mean, that's it's a style, choice.
I think it was handcrafted, so...
Yes, well, yeah. Anyway.
Children of the world put together Small World.
Yeah. Child labor built this attraction. I love it. I know exactly what you mean. It looks very, it's minimalist, which I'm a huge fan of.
Yeah.
It's not like scary vampire bats. It's just like cut out silhouettes of bats. Like all of Winifred Street. And can I talk about my favorite one? Which is everybody's favorite, the Carthay Circle restaurant.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Coming off of, is it a bell tower?
Yeah.
The tower at the top of the Carthay Circle restaurant. They have basically like these rods coming out of it with all these bats all over it. It is one of the most beautiful visuals I've actually ever seen in holiday decorating at the parks. Like it is so minimalist, beautiful. It's just stunning. And I kind of thought I was just, because I'm a little weird when it comes to stuff, I thought it was just me that felt this way. Instagram disagrees.
Yeah.
Everybody is posting photos of these bats coming out of the top of the Carthay. Stunning. Whoever came up with this design, bravo. Bravo, bravo, bravo. Love it.
Did you get a chance to see the lighting?
At night? Yeah. Okay. Like, not the actual like moment that they light it, but I've seen it lit up.
It's beautiful lit up. And they do like, it's a small thing, but they have Oogie's voiceover, and all the lights in the trees come on like sporadically, and then like there's like a lighting ceremony and fog comes out.
So you mentioned lights in the trees. I have very strong opinions about holiday lights for Halloween. I'm getting better about this.
Okay.
But I was very adamantly against this originally. Like, holiday lights are for Christmas.
Are you talking about this year or just like...
In the last couple of years, in general, I've always... Since, like, we started with orange lights and purple lights and stuff, I've always been like... And people hanging them on their trees outside. I'm like, this is a Christmas thing. Like, why are we doing this for Halloween now?
Twinkle lights are for all the time, Jeff.
I disagree.
Twinkle lights are for all the time.
I disagree with that statement, but I gotta
leave a comment below if you think twinkle lights are for all the time.
I will say the purple ones on Buena Vista Street are gorgeous, and even the orange ones in the Halloween tree over in Frontierland are beautiful. So my mind has changed considerably when it comes to Halloween holiday lights. I will say it belongs in the handcrafted family style design. It does not belong in haunts. That I'm still against it.
Oh, well, that seems obvious.
Well, I don't, dude. I've gone to haunted attractions that use purple lights and stuff.
I don't know.
Not a fan of in that perspective. But on Buena Vista Street, beautiful purple twinkle lights everywhere.
Did you take any time to look in the shop windows too?
A little bit.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There was some, there's a ton of like old fashioned Halloween, which is cool.
I love retro Halloween.
Yeah, it's really cool. There's actually a couple of places where it was, I don't want to say morbid, but borderline like dark.
Yeah.
And in one of the windows, there's like drawings of anatomy and like musculature, and not like that's not dark, but yeah, just for a Disney park, I was just like, oh, this is really cool. But
yeah,
they have a ton of cool Halloween products, but we won't get into that. I could just like,
I haven't checked out the shopping too much.
I didn't buy anything, but they've just got some really cool.
I do like the Mickey jack-o'-lantern made out of steel.
Yes.
Very cool, but like $40.
Yeah.
But I will say at the end of Buena Vista Street, if you look to the left, there's quite a nice little surprise.
Yeah.
The Headless Horseman has a statue at the end of Buena Vista Street, right across from the Carthay Circle restaurant. It is a cool statue.
It's super cool.
And is that the fog you were talking about earlier?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
At night, first of all, I should say all of this at night, all of this is beautiful during the daytime. At nighttime, like 10 times more beautiful with the lighting and the fog coming out of the horse's nostrils. It's beautiful.
He's part of the lighting ceremony too.
Oh, okay.
He comes to life and he talks and
okay.
Like the I don't know if it's all night, but the pumpkin, his head like flickers.
Yeah,
the light,
his head flickers. Yeah,
and you know the horse whinnies and stuff. It's cool because when they first said statue, I was expecting like a bronze statue, but it's made like it's made to look like he's real?
Frozen in time.
Yeah, like, yeah, yeah, like he's, I mean, it's actual costumes.
Yeah, the pumpkin is orange.
Yeah.
It's awesome. Like,
yeah.
Sleepy Hollow is phenomenal. Honestly, I would love to see, and I know we've got the Adventures of Ichabod and Mr. Toad short.
Yeah.
But, and I know we've got the Johnny Depp, you know, Sleepy Hollow from, what was that, 1999, I believe, that Tim Burton did. I would kind of like to see Disney do a live action Sleepy Hollow.
That'd be cool.
I love the story of Sleepy Hollow. Iconic Halloween. Yeah, just love it. So it's that was a beautiful, beautiful touch, I think.
Yeah.
One thing that I think is interesting, now the music, I believe, changes throughout the day. As you're exiting later at night, they're playing different music. The Beetlejuice theme is played, and
I don't think it's Beetlejuice.
No, it's bum, 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 bum. It's definitely Beetlejuice.
I don't know.
No, it is. Like, trust me. It's the music from Beetlejuice. And Beetlejuice is one of the most, I love the score, but it's one of the most overused scores ever. Like, if you go back to, like, the 90s, when they make movie trailers, they often don't have the score of the film ready yet. They use the Beetlejuice score for so many movie trailers in the 90s. It's crazy. I'm like, what is this? Like, it's appropriate for every style? It was nuts. But yeah, it's definitely the Beetlejuice score.
I bet it's like a, really close appropriation of the Beatles.
I'll make a churro bet with you.
Okay.
Right now. It is the Beetlejuice score.
Okay.
I don't even eat churros.
I bet if you Shazammed it, like, it would not come up Beetlejuice.
I'll make you a cheese pretzel.
Oh, yeah.
Cheese pretzel
I'll
bet.
I'll take that
shake
bet.
On it, yeah. On camera.
Yeah.
Okay, we're looking into this. But in any case, I think it's weird the Beetlejuice music is kind of used everywhere, even though it's not Disney. But in any case, that's the entrance to Disney California Adventure. It's lovely. And the other place, oh, I forgot to mention the character costumes.
Oh.
So the characters, the Fab Five are, of course, all over, hanging over, well, depending on your definition of the Fab Five, are hanging out on Buena Vista Street. Because it's Daisy, not Pluto. Daisy is not Fab Five, in my opinion.
That's right. Well, because I was going to say, I don't think Pluto's in there.
No,
but
not Pluto,
yeah,
but Daisy.
You're right.
But Daisy is dressed as a witch, very retro witch. Mickey has like a suit and top hat.
He's a vampire.
Is he?
Yeah, he's got a cape.
Oh, I didn't see fangs.
That's a bat wing. Okay,
excuse me. He's a vampire with a top hat.
Yeah.
I love how upset you are. He's a vampire.
Yeah.
Okay, I apologize. Minnie's a flapper. Goofy is dressed as a ghost. And Donald is a devil. I think the Donald one's probably my favorite. Yeah. Very, very cute.
Goofy and Donald are definitely my favorite.
But here's what I want to see next year for their Halloween costumes. I want to see them cosplaying as Pixar characters. I want to see...
Why?
Because I just think it would be great to see Mickey cosplaying as Buzz Lightyear.
Oh.
And Donald...
If they were going to do it, they'd do it at Disneyland.
No. Why? Well, I see. Because to keep with the point... I'm just saying, in general, I think it would be great to see the Disney characters cosplay as other Disney characters.
Yes.
I think that would be a hoot and a holler.
Yeah.
Holla. But as I was going to say before, the other big celebration of Halloween at Disney California Adventure is Cars Land. Holy moly.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive.
Yeah. And of course, Cars Land does a phenomenal job at Christmas as well.
Yeah.
But that has kind of become the land to decorate because of like the fun... I don't know if is puns the right word.
Well, I'm always confused by Cars Land decorations because it's like
the cannibalism of
it. Yeah, it's cannibalism. It's like they're basically like appropriating parts from themselves to. Yeah, it's weird.
It is weird, but if you can just get past that, it's so much fun.
Yeah.
What was some of your favorite stuff from Cars Land?
I just love the obviously the garlands that are across the street that look like monster faces.
Yeah, so they've got the orange cones as like sharp teeth and the tires as eyeballs.
Yeah, I like the Dia de los Muertos setup. There's like a paper mache car that's painted up like the sugar skull. And then there's a whole there's a really weird like tribute to the Hudson Hornet, Doc Hudson,
mm-hmm.
inside of Ramones mm-hmm. body shop. Which, did you go check it out?
I haven't not seen.
Oh, it's really strange because it's like it's a memorial.
Oh, but he's in the ride.
Yeah, I know. That's why it was.
There's
weird.
A lot of let's just talk about the continuity errors in Radiator Springs Racers. It's always nighttime. Problem number one. The attraction takes place in Radiator Springs, like you're driving through the streets that you just walked down.
Right.
In the dark ride portion, problem number two. And now Doc's alive in there, yet dead in the land. Don't even get me going. It's a fun ride, though.
Yeah.
But continuity is key.
I'm also a huge fan of foods.
Yes, you know, yeah.
And they've got a bunch of Halloween.
They've got a spicy mac and cheese and a black cone, yeah. Which I don't know what they call it, but I had it.
It's very good.
It was good, and it was actually spicy.
Yeah.
I think I'm actually getting a bit weaker in the mouth, because lately I've noticed, like, I'm like, oh, that's spicy. And I used to not be that way. I don't know. Anywho, so my favorite, of course, is they have this section with movie poster parodies. Yeah. And I'm even forgetting what a lot of them are, like, old sci-fi type of movies. But there's one, Hocus Pocus, which is just fantastic. Three cars on the broomsticks in the style of the very famous Hocus Pocus poster. So
they've got Escape from Hitch Mountain.
Oh, okay. I like it. Yeah, it's so clever, a lot of these names that they come up with. Now, the car characters are actually in costume as well. Yeah. Lightning McQueen is dressed as a superhero. Yep. The fire truck is dressed as a clown.
Wait, what?
You haven't seen the photos?
No.
The fire truck's dressed as
a clown. I haven't seen Red anywhere around.
Yeah, dressed as a clown. Mater is a vampire. It's very cool. Now, I'm a little surprised, and I think part of this might be because...
You left off Cruz.
What's Cruz dressed
Cruz as? Cruz is a pirate.
There we go.
She's the coolest.
Cruz is a pirate. The one thing that surprised me a little bit, just because it would be kind of easy, so that may be why they steered away from it, or they may have steered away because of steered away. Ah, pun not intended. We're driving cars land steering. Okay, anyway. The giant cones at the Cozy Cone Motel all have, like, jack-o'-lantern type of faces in them. I'm a little surprised they're not candy corn. Maybe because of the past
You're just sour about candy corn.
I'm not sour about candy corn
you
at all.
You just want the candy corn.
I'm just a little, like, I think that would have
They have
worked.
A candy corn... Cozy Cone Macaron.
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
Oh, I should get that. Yeah. But yeah, I don't know. I feel like candy corn, orange cones would be great.
Have you seen the Psycho house?
You mean at Universal Studios?
No, in Cars Land.
No, where?
Yeah, it's inside the Cozy Cone motel.
Oh, like where Buzz is not, like,
yeah.
Okay.
Inside, there's like a little diorama, and there's the Psycho house.
I like that.
Yeah, it's weird too, because there's like splattered oil, like
like it's blood
splatter.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, it's pretty wild.
They also have, like, spider webs made out of wrenches, which I think is super cool. They have pumpkins made out of gas tanks, which I think is really funny. It's just so much fun. Of course, the smaller attractions there as well were overlaid with Halloween. Luigi's Honkin' Halloween is there, as well as Mater's Graveyard Jamboree.
It's really more they swapped the songs.
The music, yeah.
The music is different. And I couldn't even tell with Luigi's if it was different, if they completely did new songs, or if it was just the old songs with new lyrics and like a spooky score.
Yeah, I just gotta say, overall, they did it right.
Yeah,
Cars Land,
a lot for just, like, overhauling their Halloween for this year.
Yeah, I personally loved it, and I'm all for it. And I definitely think we'll be returning and probably being plussed. Also at Disney California Adventure for Halloween, of course, the newest attraction there, am I right in still saying that, is Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout.
That's right.
Yet it already has a Halloween overlay called Guardians of the Galaxy Monsters After Dark. Monsters After Dark! That's the song. Yes, there's an original song in the attraction. There's only one version of this. And it takes place just seconds after the end ride, or after you get off the ride of Mission Breakout. So the storyline continues. It's pretty cool. What were your thoughts on Monsters After Dark?
I don't know. I haven't done it.
You still haven't done it?
No.
Why not?
Well, because I just haven't been in the park after dark.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I have been in the park after dark, but I haven't been there when there was... when it was available.
Interesting.
Yeah.
It's fun. I very much enjoyed it. I don't prefer it to the original attraction. I definitely like the original better, but I've heard people say differently. The song is a very generic rocker, like just screaming monsters after dark. I like the six other songs more, but it's a lot of fun. It does feature only Groot, primarily Groot and Rocket. There's no Chris Pratt or anything, so it's like, come on, take Chris Pratt out, and that immediately deters. But it's fun because, you know, you go in the office, I guess.
Yeah.
Tavon's office. And Rocket's like, what are you guys still doing here? Like, it's really fun.
That was terrible.
Shut up. So mean. And so it's just fun. The one thing, for continuity's sake, I very much appreciate this, is in the lobby. Or, I don't know. What do you call it now?
Oh, it's the museum. It's
the museum.
It's the collection.
In the collection, at the beginning. The first part you go into. They actually cover up the case with the dog inside, because at the end of Mission Breakout...
He gets out.
The dog gets out. So they cover it up, and it says, you know, something like new installation in progress or something like that. So I was like, I appreciate that, because this takes place later. There's some new lighting effects in the boiler room. It's just a lot of fun. If you like Mission Breakout, you will like Monsters After Dark. I wouldn't say it's particularly Halloween-y, but monsters.
Yeah, monsters.
The one thing I will say is a huge improvement is the exterior of the building. They have lasers that are being projected on it now, and it's really, you know, for it being the ugliest building on Disney property, it's improved.
At nighttime, it's cool. It's super cool. I mean, because it doesn't, you know.
I did ask an Imagineer something recently.
Oh.
Because it is the ugliest building on Disney property.
Is that how you phrased it?
I mean, a little nicer than that.
Oh, okay.
But, so if you've seen this building, there is a big black void in the middle of it. And it just never made sense to me. Like, it's really obvious during the daytime.
It bothered me too.
It's very, 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 very ugly. You've got like tons of colors everywhere and tubing and piping and all this stuff going everywhere. And you just got this black void. And so I was just asking Imagineer, I was like, what is that about? Like, in story, like, you know, I'm not a Marvel guy. Maybe there's something I'm missing here. Why is there this big black void in the middle of this building? What's the story about that? And his answer was simply, it makes the other two sides look taller. And I was like, oh, all right. I will say at nighttime, it works because the sky is black and the void is black.
Yeah.
But during the daytime,
I like what they do with it for the overlay too.
With the lasers.
It's got the electricity going in between.
I'll go in between it. Yeah. So
I think they should just leave the effects on the outside.
Yeah, I wouldn't disagree. I think it looks great, and it's not particularly Halloween.
I just feel like, especially since you don't particularly care for the building, go all out. Just like
don't
hold back.
Remember for Magic Kingdom's 25th anniversary?
Yes, the cake.
Cinderella Castle cake?
Yeah.
What anniversary are we coming up on for DCA? Let's think. 2021 will be 20 years. I think we need a Guardians of the Galaxy Tower cake.
Birthday cake?
Yep.
Wow.
I think just do it.
I don't know.
You cannot make that building any uglier. Just commit and do it. Oh, I would love it. That'd be fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Now, it is interesting that this attraction got a Halloween overlay, considering Tower of Terror, the previous attraction that was there, was very much a Halloween attraction.
It happens on Halloween.
It takes place on Halloween 1939, and that was always used as a big part of the promotion for Disneyland Halloween time.
Right.
So, I think it's kind of nice that I guess we've continued the tradition of that tower being part of the Halloween tradition at the Disneyland Resort. So that is nice. What else is going on? Is there anything else super new in DCA that you want to talk about for Halloween?
Not that is... I guess the Plaza de Familia is for Halloween.
It's for Dia de los Muertos. This is... celebrate that.
It's for their fall seasonal.
Yeah, which takes place on November 1st, right? The day after Halloween.
Yeah.
And it's obviously promoting Coco.
Yeah.
But God, it's Just the, have you got a little space that's like, just like the pictures and quotes and stuff? From
yeah.
So pretty.
I know.
So, so pretty.
I told you about that.
You told me about it. I remember that. Yeah, I went and checked out.
It's cool, right?
The best thing though.
Yeah.
The tacos. Oh, seriously? I had the tacos at the little Plaza de la Familia stand. I don't know what they're officially calling it, but over by Goofy Sky School. Those tacos are delicious. I was with my sister and I was like, oh, going to get my like general just like burrito that I get a lot, the chicken burrito that they have year round. I said, hey, we're here. Let's try it. Oh, my God.
Good decision.
Those steak burritos were yummy. I really want some again. So I highly suggest that.
Highest praise right there.
No, really
yummy.
Good. Yes, very yummy. And that happens, that's going on through November 2nd. So worth checking out. They have, of course, the mariachi bands and live performances in addition to that. But yeah, it's pretty fun. But the big question now is, everybody's asking with Disney California Adventure doing all this Halloween stuff, does this mean that Mickey's Halloween Party will be moving back across the Esplanade over to Disney California Adventure?
Yes.
My opinion is yes. Yeah. I don't think there's been anything officially announced, right?
No.
No. So yeah, I think that that's what this is pointing to. And I guess we should discuss what would we like to see, because obviously they got to do more than they're doing now to make it an extra ticketed event. So what do we want to see go there? And I guess what will we miss from the Disneyland one?
Well, before we get to a party,
sure.
The thing that I want to see is Hollywood Boulevard.
Yeah.
Dressed.
Here's the thing. I feel like they don't want to invest in that because they know Marvel it's going to be going away. So they're like, why put the money into decorating that for like 2 years of use?
It's just weird to me that you get to the end of Buena Vista Street and then you take a left and it's like Halloween's over.
Let's just do a really, really, really dark, cryptic Monsters, Inc. overlay. Ooh. I would like that. That'd be great. Anyway, I think for that reason, though, I don't think they'll touch it personally. Yeah. But that would be nice. Speaking of Hollywood Boulevard, though, Hollywood Boulevard leads directly to the Hyperion Theater.
That's right.
Home of Frozen Live. What's it called? Frozen a Musical Spectacular?
Frozen, who cares?
But, of course, I think if we're gonna move Mickey's Halloween Party there, we need a live show on stage.
And what would be a good live show, Jeff?
Let me think. I mean, why spend money on a new stage show, right?
Yeah.
Why not bring the Hocus Pocus Villain Spelltacular from the Magic Kingdom to the Hyperion Theater?
You know, I hadn't thought about that.
Yeah, I'm sure everybody's thought of this. It just makes sense.
Well, they could plus it so easily in that space.
They too. Could fly.
Yeah, they could fly.
They could fly.
They could literally fly around the stage. And they've got that screen that could easily, create all kinds of environments.
I'll tell you what, I will be pissed if they put a live show in there that isn't Hocus Pocus related.
I don't know.
Like, no, that just makes too much sense.
It's actually going to become the Hocus Pocus villains. No. So actually, it's going to be Mater and Lightning McQueen.
I don't think we need that. I think that is kind of a given. And if it doesn't happen, that's actually really irritating. I also think that this whole Guardians of the Galaxy Monsters After Dark, you better do it this year. Because I don't think that's going to be a normal daytime ticket activity once the party goes there. I think that'll be just for the party.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah, because that's what they did with the Hallowishes fireworks, although we don't call it that.
It wouldn't be. It'd be like,
I'm telling you,
it'd be like Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy.
No, because that runs all day.
Yeah, I know. But I mean, it's still like, it's so easy to turn that on.
Okay, I'll bet you a churro on this.
I don't want a churro.
I'll bet you
another cheese pretzel.
Steak taco from Plaza de la Familia.
We won't know. Maybe that won't be back. Okay. We don't know.
Another pretzel.
Okay, yeah, the pretzel's good. Fine. I'm good with the pretzel.
I would bet money.
I don't think so.
Because here's the thing. They did this before the party moved back to Disneyland. They had a Halloween fireworks show. I think it was only 1 year. Played during normal park hours. And then when they moved the party over there, in order to have the party, you really need stuff that you can't do otherwise to get people to pay for that ticket.
Right.
So the easiest thing to do is say, the only way you can ride Monsters After Dark is if you come and do a Halloween party.
Okay.
I think that's going to happen.
Okay.
What else do you want to see there?
I would like to see a Halloween World of Color.
Yes. Agreed.
I would honestly just like to see that without the party.
I think, well, yes, that'd be nice. I think you would need this because by moving it to DCA, you are losing the fireworks.
Oh, yeah.
The question I have is, would the Halloween fireworks become part of normal Disneyland? Or would they just get rid of it?
Probably get rid of it.
Probably get rid of it.
Yeah.
But
it's a big production.
Flies, and they got the big full moon with the Jack Skellington projected face. It's great. So that would be a bummer of it leaving Disneyland as we lose the fireworks. Yeah. But a Halloween World of Color, I think, could be very cool.
Could be really cool.
I like that.
Based on the Christmas holiday one. So I mean, I think they could easily make something just as cool.
Oh, hey there. Sorry to be interrupting the show, but a lot of you have been writing in requesting that we make new episodes more frequently. As much as we would love to do that, we simply don't have the time. But here's the good news. You can interact with us every day of the week. No need to just wait for Wednesdays. Connect with us in places like Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Also, we'd love to interact with you in the comment sections on YouTube and read your reviews on iTunes or wherever you listen to the show. So go ahead, no more waiting around for Wednesdays to have some DCTC time. You can find all of our links at DisneyCoastToCoast.com. So I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Do you think one of the very popular over at Disneyland during Halloween time is the cadaver dance?
Oh.
Could they be moved over to Buena Vista Street and have the Dapper Dans ever appeared anywhere else? Like, aside from Magic Kingdoms?
I don't think so.
I wouldn't be surprised if, like, they have the Grand Floridian or something, but I don't recall any times that they have.
Yeah.
And is it blasphemy? Would it be crazy to take the Cadaver Dans and move them over to DCA for a Halloween party?
No.
Uh-oh. Newsboys?
We're going to get the
Vampire
we're
going to
get the Newsboys. Because I was thinking, I was like, oh, well, Buena Vista Street is themed.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's weird that they're not celebrating Halloween. They're Newsboys, man. They should be living up their Halloween dreams.
I mean, was Halloween really a thing in the early 1900s?
Sure.
I don't think so.
I don't know. Well, I mean, I'll
bet you a pretzel.
If they're decorating the whole street, then obviously in this incarnation of Buena Vista of California, sure, they're celebrating Halloween.
I think more realistically, what would happen, it would be more likely to see a Five and Dime Halloween show than we would a Newsboys.
I only said Newsboys because I knew that would float your boat.
I love it.
Yeah.
Newsboys can float my boat any day.
Oh, wow.
I don't know what that means.
Okay.
But I think the Cadaver Dans are a big hit. I think they would fit on Buena Vista Street, in my opinion, but I don't know if there's like some rule about the Dapper Dans in general. But frankly, it's not the Dapper Dans, it's the Cadaver Dans. So we can do whatever we want with them. I think that would be cool.
They're undead, so.
The other thing that I would miss from Disneyland is, I don't know if you've ever seen it, but the Rivers of America during the Halloween party is stunningly beautiful. The lighting in the fog is just fantastic during the Halloween party.
Yeah.
I would miss that. I think it's smart for them. I'm talking like it's an official thing. It has not been officially announced. But I think it's smart for them to move it over to DCA. I think that obviously it's become very crowded over at Disneyland. I'm assuming the parade, the Frightfully Fun Parade, would move to DCA. That would stay part of it. But yeah, I think it's a smart move, especially with Star Wars Land and construction and all that jazz. It just makes sense.
I don't think it would move until Star Wars Land opens.
Oh, really? You don't think it'll happen next year?
No.
I'm thinking next year.
No. I think they'll...
I'll bet you a pretzel.
Wow, I'm going to have a lot of pretzels.
No, I'm going to have a lot of pretzels.
I'll help you with those pretzels. Yeah. I don't know. I think that I would like to see them expand the decorations before they bring the party there.
Oh, well, they can do that all in one year. I think
Yeah, I see what... Yeah,
I think Paradise Pier or Pixar Pier will... could be a cool place, especially since Toy Story has that Halloween special ABC. Yeah. What's it called?
Toy Story of Terror.
Yeah. That would be kind of cool to work into Pixar Pier, perhaps.
That'd be cool.
I think DCA is a good home for Halloween. I think it works. I just hope that this doesn't mean we lose, like, the way that DCA really before this year didn't have I should say in the hiatus years, didn't have any Halloween decorations. I certainly hope that that's not what happens to Disneyland by the party moving.
No, it won't.
There's
too many permanent fixtures like Haunted Mansion, Holiday, and Ghost Galaxy is so easy to.
Yeah, I was thinking more like Main Street and stuff.
Why would they get rid of the pumpkins and stuff?
I don't know.
No, no. Celebrating the seasons on Main Street.
Why get rid of the candy corn?
Well, because candy corn is dumb.
Stupid. You're stupid. Leave a comment below on YouTube. Do you love candy corn? Does candy corn make the Halloween season more Halloween-y?
No.
The answer is yes.
No. They would never do that because Main Street is about celebrating
the season. I'm just playing devil's advocate.
It wouldn't go away.
Okay. Anything else over at DCA you want to talk about for their Halloween specialty?
I want to see a Halloween Soarin' overlay.
Ooh, we could like travel to Transylvania.
Sure, yeah.
Where are like other scary places? I'm gonna leave this alone. Yeah, this is gonna get way too political.
I just went to real world places.
This
like,
is politically incorrect.
I'd like to see Grizzly River Run with a Halloween overlay, and it's like a kids getting lost in the forest story.
Oh my god, that is the Red Creek, the Redwood Challenge place thingamajiggy, Redwood Creek Trail.
There you go.
That could, dude, you could do like a haunted maze in there.
It could be cool.
Not that they would. Yeah. But speaking of, can we segue?
Yeah, sure.
Speaking of a scary Halloween's at the Disney parks, we unfortunately don't have anything like this, but Hong Kong does. off of Main Street, interestingly enough, they label this as age interest all ages, which let me tell you, in America, that would not be the age interest. Maze of Madness, the nightmare experiment continues. This is kind of a spinoff / sequel of a previous maze they've done there for their Halloween season. It is like a Halloween haunted house maze with Disney characters, and it looks awesome.
Yeah, it does look cool.
I'm all for it. Did you see? So, like, they have the Monsters Inc. doors, and
that's
and
my favorite part.
The Child Detection Agency.
Yeah.
And super creepy. No, my favorite part is definitely the chained up Pinocchio.
Oh, God.
With, like, this
so
demented,
weird.
I've got no strings. And he's, like, chained there and can't get away. Fantastic.
And he, like, comes at you.
Oh, it's so cool.
Yeah.
The Mad Hatter is in there being all weird and Mad Hattery.
It looked like he's, like, cutting people's heads off. There was shriveled heads.
He's turned into the Queen of Hearts.
Yeah.
It also features some Beauty and the Beast and stuff from Hercules as well. It's just a very, very dark maze at Hong Kong Disneyland. And I can tell you, that's a good reason to visit Hong Kong during the Halloween season. I'm all for this. But what's the... Over at Disneyland, they actually added something very nice and new.
Yeah.
To the Frightfully Fun Parade.
Yeah.
My girl.
Your girl.
My girl, Ursula.
Yeah.
Has made it. Now, granted, I understand Ursula is a very tough character to move around in shows and such. So when she was not part of the Frightfully Fun Parade villains float last year, I was not that surprised. But she's in there this year. Have you seen this?
Yeah, she's like a puppet.
She's like a Segway puppet.
A Segway puppet?
She's like, she's rolling around like she's on a Segway.
Oh, well, yeah, more. She's got more.
Hoverboard.
She's got a little bit more action than the Segway. Yeah. She can get around. But
it's very cool.
Yeah.
I love it. She's floating on the pavement.
Well, because you initially told me it was a float, I thought it was going to be like the old Fantasmic where it was like just like kind of a blow up.
Well,
this actually has a performer.
Well, so did the Fantasmic one, because her arms moved.
It did not
moved.
Have a performer inside.
It had a puppeteer. The arms moved.
Well, maybe a puppeteer, but this is like a life-size human. There's a human inside of there who is performing.
There's a human inside the other one, too, but it was much bigger. I'll bet you a pretzel. but it's cool. I'm very thrilled to have that addition to the Frightfully Fun Parade, which I still have not seen in person because I just will not pay for Mickey's Halloween party. But maybe if I cause enough of a headache, then they'll give me it for free. No, I was very, very lucky to do the Disney Parks Blog Meetup Halloween party one year, and it was great. It's just, as an annual pass holder, it's a pretty pricey add-on. But yeah, I think that wraps up Halloween this year. Of course, there's so much more going on at the Walt Disney World and even at the Disneyland park. But it's a lot of repeated stuff from previous years. So we wanted to talk to you a bit about the new stuff that was very exciting. It's an exciting Halloween year for the Disneyland Resort. Yeah. So anyway, I think that means
it's trivia time. Hey folks, welcome to today's trivia time. Today I have Laurens joining me from the Netherlands. He is an Instagram Disney photographer as well as a former cast member. Hello, Laurens, how are you?
Thank you, that's a great introduction.
Oh, do you like that?
Sure.
Sure. Well, today we're here for trivia about Splash Mountain. Do you like Splash Mountain? Do you like that attraction?
Oh yeah, it's my favorite one in Walt Disney World, yeah.
Is it really?
It is, yes.
Oh, that's cool. No, does Paris have that attraction? I'm not even sure.
No, they planned to do it, but the weather is not very good in Paris, so no splash for Paris.
That makes sense. It would be closed a lot of the year. But yeah, let's get to some Splash Mountain trivia. What do you got for me?
Let me see. I don't know if you noticed, but it could be. In the development process of doing Splash Mountain at Disneyland, which other Disney character came in mind of the Imagineers, other than Briar Rabbit and Briar Fox and Briar Bear, of course, to be present in Splash Mountain? Which other Disney character?
Now, I'm not sure if this is the direction you're going, but I know that at the time of Splash Mountain construction, Michael Eisner was really like dead set on the movie Splash, starring Tom Hanks. So are you talking about the mermaid from the movie Splash, or is it something different?
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, the mermaid.
Is that the one that you're talking about?
Yes.
Yeah, it's a very weird story when it comes to that, because originally the attraction was going to be called something like a Zippity-Doo-Dah Run or something, you know, obviously something much more related to Song of the South, which the attraction is based on. But part of the reason why I got the name Splash Mountain is because Michael Eisner was like very, you know, Splash was a huge hit for the Walt Disney Company. And it's weird and interesting. I can't even imagine if there was just like a random mermaid in that ride. Like, that'd be the weirdest thing.
Yeah, that would not fit with the other characters, I guess.
No, not at all. Very cool. Well, for my Splash Mountain trivia, what I got here is... So there's a Splash Mountain at Disneyland in California, as well as at Walt Disney World. Do you know which lands they are in at Disneyland and at Walt Disney World?
Well, I know Walt Disney World is, Splash Mountain is in Frontierland.
That's correct. Any idea where at Disneyland?
I believe there is a land in Disneyland which is not in the Magic Kingdom in Orlando. Mm-hmm. Which is, I guess, if I pronounce it correctly, Scissor Country?
Close. Critter Country.
Critter Country, okay.
Yeah, so like a little critter, like a squirrel or something. It's Critter Country. It's one of two attractions in Critter Country. There's just Splash Mountain, and originally it was Bear Country, because it's where the Country Bear Jamboree, when it used to be at Disneyland, was. And then, I'm not sure exactly when it changed to Critter Country, but now it's Critter Country. Splash Mountain's there, and our Winnie the Pooh dark ride is there. Which is very weird, because I know at the Magic Kingdom, like, that's a very popular dark ride. It's in Fantasyland, and there's always a line for it. But here at Disneyland, pretty dead most of the time, because it's so in the back corner. I even know of people who are, like, regular Disneyland Park visitors who didn't even know that it existed there. So it's a...
Well, that's actually the reason why Splash Mountain was built, right? Because the area was so quiet, so they needed a big attraction, I guess.
That may be true. Yeah, they definitely, you know, I feel like whenever Disney has the opportunity to build another e-ticket attraction, they'll take advantage of it. So it's kind of crazy. There's actually another fun little fact about the Magic Kingdom Splash Mountain that I came across. There's a scene, I don't know exactly when it is, but there's a little gopher that sneezes. But instead of sneezing, he's actually saying the initials of something. Do you have any idea what I'm talking about?
No.
Okay. Well, if you go back and listen to this little gopher sneezing, he actually, instead of saying like, achoo, he sang FSU. So he's like, FSU. And that stands for Florida State University, which.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. So go back and check that out. It's kind of funny. I never knew that. So FSU. Anyway, thank you so much, Lawrence, for coming on the show today. Once again, you can follow him on Instagram, LaurenceKoning95. Check it out, some spectacular photos from Walt Disney World as well as Disneyland Paris. Thank you very much.
That's right. Thank you very much.
Okay, Aaron, did you enjoy that trivia?
Yeah.
The answer is yeah, absolutely. Guys, thanks for joining. Before we go, gotta give a shout out. I gotta give a shout out to Aaron.
Which Aaron?
Aaron Onish.
Aaron Onish.
Hey, Aaron Onish. Thanks so much for leaving us a 5-star review on iTunes. That's how you get a shout out on the show, folks. It's so simple. Go to iTunes, leave that 5-star review for us, and it helps other Disney fans find the show. So thank you so much, Aaron Onish. Very much appreciated. But I think that's going to do it for us this week, yeah?
Yeah.
Hey, Aaron.
Hey.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. What does he say? Happy holidays, everyone. And then he says something like that.
I don't even know who that was.
It's Jack Skellington in Haunted Mansion Holiday.
Sure.
Something like that. Happy Halloween, everybody. Have a magical, safe Halloween night. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching Disney Coast to Coast. Have a magical day.